The lack of a health secretary by this point in his administration seems to show President Marcos is not prioritizing the sector. Former Health Secretary Esperanza Cabral says without a clear leadership, the agency will have a hard time pushing for reforms aimed at addressing the pandemic and other emerging health issues.
Kung mahusay ang Secretary of Health na inappoint, ay maisip niya na hindi lamang COVID ang responsibilidad ng Department of Health, kung hindi marami pang ibang issues tungkol sa kalusugan ang dapat tuunan ng pansin. Napakarami ng problema natin tungkol sa kalusugan, kailangan siguro ay i-prioritize nila kung ano yung una nilang gagawin. Pero dapat mula dun sa idea na yon ay magkaroon ng implementasyon para magkaroon ng impact sa ating mga kababayan.
Cabral, meanwhile, commends Health Officer in Charge Maria Rosario Vergere for stepping up even without the title of a secretary.
Pagka officer in charge ka, hindi mo masyadong ma-i-push yung kailangan mong policy agenda para sa Department of Health. We really need to give credit to the officer in charge ha, ngayon dahil sa kahit na officer in charge siya, ay naglabas siya ng tinatawag na health strategy for 2023 to 2028. Hindi ko alam kung ito ay sinyales para sa atin na siya actually ang magiging Secretary of Health or talaga lamang na para sa kanya ay mahalaga na gawin ito kaya hindi, miski hindi siya secure sa position niya.
Person of interest in the killing of broadcaster Percival Percy Lapid Mabasa has been spotted in CCTV footage released by police. Our very own Jack Batalliones now joins us with more on that story. Jack, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, the Special Investigation Task Group Percy Lapid has developed a person of interest in the case of the slain broadcaster. This person, Carmina, is the actual gunman or the assassin in this case. He was identified through the CCTV footage and dashcam video obtained by the police. Based on the video, the gunman was seen waiting for Mabasa's vehicle just outside Las Piñas City Hall. The rider of the motorcycle was also caught on video waiting for the victim, and as Mabasa passed by, they scrambled to get on the motorcycle. CCTV footage also showed that the suspects tailed Mabasa until he reached the gate of BF Resort where he was gunned down. The suspects made a U-turn as they fled the scene. DILG Secretary Benher Abalos said that based on what he saw, the gunman was a professional. The investigators also noted that the suspects probably studied the usual route of Mabasa and that the entrance gate going to BF Resort was their best opportunity to ambush Mabasa. They also went through the cell phone of Mabasa, but according to the SITG, they saw no information relevant to the case. The PNP released a poster of the gunman and a 1.5 million reward was offered to those who can give any information that would lead to the identification of the suspects. Meanwhile, to preempt a similar event to happen in the future, the NCRPO directed all district directors and chiefs of police to initiate a dialogue to all journalists, broadcasters, and media practitioners in their respective areas to determine imminent threats, if any, and address their security concerns accordingly. Carmina.
All right, Jack, just one question for you. Do we have anything on the security guards who were supposed to be manning their posts, yet they were missing at the time of the, or when the crime happened?
Well, actually, Carmina, no, we asked that about the witnesses. Then they told us, yeah, they gathered yung mga salaysay na, eto mga security guards. Another thing to note, no, Carmina, we were actually trying to ask whether may motive na dito sa crime na to, dito sa shooting na to. But I was, I asked nga kanina, I know they were able to sift through the cell phone of Mabasa, but I was actually surprised na at the same time, they also said that the family has been getting death threats or even Mabasa, but according to them, the ACG found no threats or, again, information that would be relevant to this case. Sana we were hoping na baka doon pa lang sa cellphone, makakita na tayo ng motive. Pero sa ngayon, wala pa yung motive. Hindi pa nila nire-release actually, Carmina, yung statements from the security guards. Actually, pati yung vehicle na nasa harap, na if you could recall the video, may binangga. Pero right now, all they released was the CCTV footage and the dashcam footage. And at the same time, yun nga, yung enhanced version ng CCTV video para hoping na ma-identify yung gunman.
Mm-mm. Pero nakausap na nila yung mga security guards.
Yes, so actually sinabi na nag-gather na sila ng statements from the security guards. Yun yung pagkakasabi sa atin, and at the same time mga kaanak and possible witnesses dito sa case. Pero hindi pa nila ni-release for media.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it at that. Jack Batalion is there joining us on the line. Thanks, Jack. Take care and keep safe.